2, 1, 0.
Hello and welcome to WSTC News. I'm Zach Rigby.
And I'm Ambria Stolte. This student-operated newscast is brought to you by the Belmont Harrison Career Center in St. Clairsville High School.
On February 3rd, news emerged that ISIS had burned a Jordanian captive to death. The Jordanian nation hit back and is now promising more. Austin Ryan has more on the story.
Thursday, February 5th, Jordanian fighter jets carried out an airstrike on ISIS, then returned and flew over 27-year-old pilot's house to show respect for him and his family. I caught up with some students and faculty to get more.
How do you feel about Jordan's retaliation on ISIS?
Well, you can certainly understand where they're coming from. There's two sides of every argument, but with the violence that's been going on over there, it would be hard not to lash out and retaliate in some fashion. It's just a matter of how you want to address it, but retaliation is almost inevitable with what they've been doing.
Well, I actually have mixed feelings, to retaliate. Like, a lot of innocent people are probably going to be killed. However, there's evil in the world, and sometimes you have to stand up to it, and it's a bad situation.
I think it's understandable because Jordan and ISIS had a promise going on there, and they kind of broke it. So it's not called for. Killing people was never called for, but I can see why they did it.
What do you think the U.S. will do?
You know, that's hard to say. That's like asking what way the wind's going to blow tomorrow. I don't really claim to have an in with the White House and know what they're going to be doing. I think they'll do whatever the American public pushes them to do. The larger the outcry from the American population, the more likely the U.S. is to get involved in all this.
I think the U.S. will maybe give air support, but I think they'll stay at bay as far as ground troops are concerned. Coming off of a couple wars recently, I don't think the American people are ready for another ground war.
Hopefully they don't do anything, because we already poke our heads into too many other people's stuff. So I think we should just stay out of it and let it play out itself. But if it gets bad enough, if they start harming some more of our allies, I think we're going to stick our head in.
Why is it important for students and young Americans to understand what's going on?
Well, world affairs are something that eventually, even if they don't seem to affect us today, they do. There's so much out there that has an impact on our daily lives that we don't realize, whether it's oil prices and gas prices or what our military men and women are doing. But it has a big impact on us and the people closely related to us. So being from the United States, we have a large role in world affairs, and it's important that we understand why we're doing what we're doing.
It's important because, once the world is a dangerous place, some of our students are going to be forced to, not forced, but to go into those situations, and we should just be aware of terrorism in general.
I think it's important because not that many people know what's going on in the world. They're too worried about like sports and entertainment, and what really matters is your life, and if you don't know what's going on, they could take your life without you even knowing.
As ISIS continues on their rampage, Jordan and the U.S. figures out a plan to stop them. From WSTC News, I'm Austin Ryan. Back to you.
As Cupid begins his annual fight through the hearts of loved ones, many begin to worry about the damage that is going to be done to their wallets. WSTC's Abby Gresham has more on the story.
How much do you plan on spending on your loved one this Valentine's Day? The National Retail Federation's Valentine's Day Consumer Spending Survey claims that the average person will spend $142.31 this year, up from the $133.91 last year, expecting consumers to spend $18.9 billion overall. Why do you think it's necessary to spend so much on Valentine's Day?
I think it's necessary because my girlfriend, she puts up with a lot. She deals with me on a daily basis, and I love her to death, so I think it's necessary to spend as much money as it takes to make them happy.
Do you think Valentine's Day is worth being a national holiday?
Well, I do. I think it should be a national holiday, but I have a few stipulations. We need more good things, positive things, more love in the world, so would be a positive holiday, but I think maybe we should have 3 days off of school, for this new holiday. Also, businesses should close, and yeah, we should really just relax and enjoy the new Valentine's Day.
1 in 5 shoppers will buy Valentine's Day gifts for their pets, spending about $5.28 on average. Do you think Valentine's Day is overrated? If so, why?
Well, I've been married for 14 years, and my wife has told me it's not overrated, and I am supposed to believe and follow her opinions.
9 in 10 people say they will buy their loved one something on Valentine's Day, spending an average of nearly $88. More than half plan to buy candy, 1 in 5 plan on buying jewelry, more than a third buy flowers and a night on the town. Women spend less than men. Men will spend double what women do, $190.53 versus $96.58, the NRF said. For WSTC News, I'm Abby Gresham. Back to you.
Don't change that dial. Stay tuned for more WSTC News.
New businesses, the St. C. Singers, countless snow days, and an award-winning science teacher are coming up next. You won't want to miss this.
Are you experiencing symptoms of depression? There is a breakthrough in the medical world for depression patients. Doctors developed a new medication called Boxed. It treats all depression symptoms with only a few minor side effects. Side effects include explosive diarrhea, hallucinations that cause you to believe you're an animal, excessive breakdancing, and loss of limbs. Ask your doctor about Boxed today.
Carry on and take advantage of the opportunities offered at the Belmont and Harrison Career Centers and learn a trade while earning your high school diploma at the same time. Check out interesting and challenging programs right now. Business, skilled trades, technical, mechanical, or personal services. You'll find Belmont and Harrison Career Centers facilities and programs truly amazing. See your guidance counselor or call the Belmont and Harrison Career Centers today at 740-695-9130 or visit their website at www.bhccenters.com.
Since the Highlands opened in 2004 with Cabela's, many businesses have followed, including powerhouses Walmart and Best Buy. In 2015, 9 new tenants are committed to bringing more to the already massive complex. Colin Smigel has more.
Are you getting tired of the same old stores at the Highlands in Ohio County? Well, we have some good news for you. The owners of the Highlands have decided to put in 9 new businesses, including Five Guys Burgers, Great Clips, Sally's Beauty, and many more. Fusion Steakhouse will be getting an upgrade, and more hotels are said to come. The Highlands will also be getting a new highway upgrade to cut back traffic that will be an interchange from Interstate 70, but don't worry, the plan for the Wild Escape theme park will still be in mind.
How do you feel about the upgrades coming to the Highlands in Ohio County?
I'm really excited about them because I really like food, and Five Guys is coming, and Primanti's came too, and I just really like burgers and food, so I'm really excited for the upgrades.
I feel very strong about it because Five Guys is going up there, and get myself a nice fat juicy burger and just a bag full of french fries that I can never finish.
Well, I hear there's a Five Guys, but I don't eat burgers, so like, I guess it's cool. A lot of people will enjoy that, but I won't.
I'm Colin Smigel reporting for WSCC News. Now back to you.
Welcome to the jungle. I mean, St. C. Singers, as their successful 2014-2015 season wraps up. WSTC's Mackenzie Otto has more on the story.
With over 40 members traveling and competing in areas like Loveland and Cuyahoga, the St. C. Singers have come a long way since their season began in November. I've interviewed some people involved with the program to get more on the story. What's the theme of this year's show?
This year's show theme is Urban Jungle. We incorporate our theme by doing some of the songs like MLK, Jungle by X Ambassadors, Welcome to the Jungle. Those are just a couple of the songs that we use.
How do you feel about this being your last year in Singers?
Truthfully, I'm kind of excited about it. I put in 4 years of Singers, and it was a good time while it lasted, but I'm ready for it to be over.
What's your favorite part of your show?
My favorite part about the Singers show would probably have to be the ballad, because we get a break from actually singing and dancing all the time.
For seniors Aaron Perkins, Mikey Bailey, Joanna Vincenzo, Sonu Tatapatri, Derek Gross, and Mercedes Bulger, the competition in Loveland on February 14th will be their last. What do you believe is the strongest part about your show?
Well, our show, our band won top overall performance group at our last competition. Singing, very strong due to Mr. Burke and his vocal coaching with the group, but just dedication overall with everybody.
What's your favorite part about the singers program?
Well, I enjoy working with all the high school kids. I am the elementary music teacher, so I don't get to be around talent and the age group that we deal with this group. But their dedication, once again, I have a lot of kids that show up after school. I don't get done till 4. You guys are done at 2, 2:30. So they come back in, set everything up, tear down. We've had late practices, weekend practices, and our performances, when we go to competitions, they leave at 4 a.m. for most of them. So huge dedication on their part, which is awesome and greatly appreciated.
Reporting for WSTC News, I'm Mackenzie Otto. Back to you.
For students at St. Clairsville, school has been just about as predictable as the Powerball. Due to cancellations and delays, many schools in the Ohio Valley are coming close to their limits. WSTC's Ambrose Stoltley has more.
In St. Clairsville, Ohio, snow days are common for students. This year, the school has used 5 calamity days, and to make up for those days, the teachers are letting their students do blizzard bags. How do you feel about the cancellations?
I feel like they were really great. The weather just came in handy. I think that we all just needed a break physically and mentally.
Well, I will be in California for a week, so my days will not be taken away. So does it really affect me?
If the school goes over, they're granted 8 calamity days. Students will have to attend school until a possible early June dismissal.
I think the school cancellations are a nice thing because it gives us some nice quality days off where we can do busy work at home. But I do not like the fact of blizzard bags. They're a waste of my time.
For WSTC News, I'm Ambria Stolte. Back to you. Now we move over to the middle school. WSTC reporter Shayla Haller brings you the complete coverage on one of the Teachers National Science Awards.
We took you to LA for the Grammys, and now we're going to Chicago for a National Science Award. Our very own St. Clairsville science teacher went above and beyond to win the special award. I caught up with her, some staff, and students for more on her achievements.
What type of award did you receive?
I received the National Science Teaching Association's Distinguished Teaching Award of 2015. And it was a national award that I applied for with the help of my principal, Mike McKeever, and found out that I won a couple weeks ago.
What was your reaction when you found out you won this award?
I was blown away. I mean, I really thought the process, the application process in itself was very detailed, very long. It was probably the longest type of resume I put together, narratives I had to write, lesson plans and data I had to include. And I did it pretty much just for the experience of that. It was kind of neat to put all my accomplishments together in one package. When I found out I got the phone call that I won, I was shocked. I mean, I'm speechless even now still talking about it. I can't believe that I actually got an award like this.
And what helped you to accomplish this achievement?
I feel very fortunate and very blessed that I've just really had really amazing coworkers, students, opportunities. Before I came to St. Clairsville, I was at Willing Jesuit University with the Challenger Learning Center, and I just had a lot of really good opportunities to meet people that have really helped me to use technology in my classroom and to meet my students and to reach them on different levels. And it's because of them that I was even considered for this award. So it's just been a great opportunity to work with all of them.
She gets an exclusive chance to have an all-expense-paid trip to Chicago, where she will be at a conference for her special award. What did you do to help Miss Meredith with this award?
Basically, I had to write a letter of recommendation for her. That was part of the process. I think she had to get several of those from numerous people throughout the school system and her previous schools that she worked at in community. But on behalf of being her boss, I wrote a letter of recommendation.
And how do you think this will reflect on our school?
I think it's tremendous. Anytime that you have somebody receive a national award, especially she's the only one in the entire United States who received the National Science Teacher Distinguished Teaching Award, that says a lot about our school and makes us feel real proud about the caliber of teacher that we have here at our school. So we feel really good about having her. Very glad to have her on our team.
How do you feel about being taught by a nationally awarded teacher?
It feels pretty amazing because having a teacher that could reach her goals can help kids learn better, motivated.
And how does this affect you as a student?
Having a teacher that reaches her goals make kids want to reach theirs, and being taught by her is a lot easier, knowing that she can help you reach yours.
For WSTC News, I'm Shayla Haller. Back to you.
WSTC will continue after this short commercial break.
Stay tuned for hearts, flowers, and candy with a Valentine's Day special.
When you sweat, you feel like you're the only person in the world. You can't wear the clothes that you would like to. You feel like you can't talk to anyone. Make sweating stop. Diafor can make sweating stop for good. Consult your doctor before taking Diafor. Do not take Diafor if you're pregnant or may become pregnant. Diafor, make sweating stop.
Are you tired of always feeling like you're dragging?
What if you could have energy all day and never crash?
Cake mix, icing, and lots of sprinkles are just a few things that bring us to the Valentine's Day season. Mrs. Food has a secret recipe on how to make some tasty treats.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Food, and I'm here to show you how to make some sweet cupcakes for the Valentine's Day holiday. First, you will need vegetable oil, water, eggs, cake mix, cupcake liners, a bowl, mixer, cupcake pans, icing, and optional sprinkles. Take the eggs, oil, water, and cake mix. Place the ingredients into the bowl and mix it with the mixer. Place the cupcake liners into the tray and pour the cake mix into the liners, filling them a little over halfway. Place the trays into the oven at 350 degrees and wait 23 minutes. Take the cupcakes out and let them cool. Ice the cupcakes, decorate, and serve. I'm Taylor Dudek, Mrs. Food. Back to you.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with WSTC Sports.
OVAC cheering, baseball, and a compelling story from up north. All this up next.
Carry on and take advantage of the opportunities offered at the Belmont and Harrison Career Centers and learn a trade while earning your high school diploma at the same time. Check out interesting and challenging programs right now. Business, skilled trades, technical, mechanical, or personal services. You'll find Belmont and Harrison Career Centers facilities and programs truly amazing. See your guidance counselor or call the Belmont and Harrison Career Centers today at 740-695-9130 or visit their website at www.bhccenters.com.
In case you haven't heard about me, my name is Handles. Before I got into this game, everybody doubted me. They told me I wasn't strong enough, they told me I wasn't fast enough, and that I didn't belong in this game. I'm like nothing you've ever seen before. I got crossovers, spin moves, the quickest first step in the game. My defense, lockdown. The reason why I'm so good is because Team Hydrate.
Hello and welcome to WSTC Sports. I'm Jake Orr.
And I'm Shelby Thoburn. Let's now turn our attention to what's happening in the wide world of sports.
Are you sad that you haven't seen any cheerleading so far this year? Don't worry, Michael Jacob was on location to get you cheered up at West Banco Arena.
From grappling on the mats to tumbling on the hardwood, I'm back at West Banco Arena to catch the OVAC cheering competition. Personally, I've caught up with some talented cheerleaders and coaches to find out how they feel about this event and what it means to them. I'm here with four-time OVAC winner Dana Bernard from St. Clairsville. Now, Dana, how much time and work goes into preparing for OVACs?
A lot of time and work goes into preparing. You fight through injuries and a lot of hardships, but it's all worth it when the day comes and you feel great on the floor. So the hard work is definitely worth it.
All right, thank you. What does the OVAC competition mean to you?
It's really exciting for me to be able to compete in OVACs because it's the one that all of my friends and family can come to.
All right, thank you. How do you feel that your girls performed today?
I think they did an excellent job. The energy level, the fans were fantastic, and I think it showed in our score sheet that they did very well.
What were you most nervous about coming into the competition today?
We had a lot of injuries this year, and it was a rebuilding year for us, so we really didn't know what it was going to be like this year. We lost five great seniors last year. Our numbers are down, and so we knew this year was going to be a little rough for us, but the girls stepped up and did a great job.
Having those several freshmen out on the hardwood today, how did that make you feel? Was that to make you nervous at all?
Absolutely. We have five or six new faces out there today, and they're freshman girls are always nervous to get out there and look at all the fans up there, and the nerves sometimes get the best of them, but I think they did a fantastic job.
All right, thank you. Keeping you updated on OVAC sports, I'm Michael Jacob from WSTC News. Back to you at the studio.
When we hear diamond in the month of February, we think of Valentine's Day. But for some Red Devil athletes, the diamond takes on a whole new meaning. Here's Tommy Stewart with more on the story.
As the St. Clairsville boys baseball team start their season, we catch up with coaches and players to see what their season entails. With all the hard work and dedication put into baseball this far, how do you think that has prepared you for the upcoming baseball season?
Personally, I think it's prepared us really well. There's a lot of good off-season workouts going on right now. A lot of the older guys are helping the younger guys out, and the team's really gelling so far, and it'll be fun to see what happens when the two guys from basketball get back, the two starters, Luke and Pat, and it should be an exciting season and a winning season.
With all the hard work and dedication the St. Clairsville baseball team has put in this year, how do you think it has prepared them for the upcoming season?
Well, I think certainly got a great opportunity to be much improved. I think with the recent upgrades at the Junior Sports Barn Complex, that I know Coach Sleva and the players have fundraised for and made some improvements there to hopefully make a better facility for us, give our players an opportunity to get more reps and be a little closer to home. So I think that's definitely a plus for the baseball program.
Preparation for the Red Devil season has been a combination of hard work and team building since off-season training began on January 5th.
I think it's prepared us because it's going to bring us together. It's going to give us good bonds, some good team chemistry. We need chemistry to help us prepare and get better and win games this season.
The St. Clairsville Red Devil baseball season will begin March 30th as they start off their season against the Martins Ferry Purple Riders. I'm Tom Stew with WSTC News, and back to you.
We now turn our attention to the National Sports Spotlight. Indiana kid Austin Hatch has overcome adversity, surviving two plane crashes and still living out his lifelong dream at the University of Michigan. WSTC's Dakota Bacon has more on the story.
A survivor of two separate plane crashes that killed five family members, Austin Hatch is now playing at the University of Michigan. What are your thoughts on the Austin Hatch story?
I think it's pretty incredible that he can survive two plane crashes and still be playing D1 basketball.
As a head basketball coach, how has the Austin Hatch story made an impact on your life?
Well, you know, it makes you think every day that every day is special. Every day, you know, it's a gift every day. And when you go to practice, you know, take advantage of it. When you go to school, take advantage of it. I think those kinds of stories bring you back to reality of what you're doing and that it is a special time. Practice is a special time to have fun, and the games are have fun because you're not guaranteed the next moment.
Experts say that one in every 3.4 million people worldwide will be in a plane crash that includes one fatality. How has Austin Hatch's story made you look at life differently?
It makes me learn to not take things for granted and that my life isn't as bad as it could be. When you're feeling down and you're feeling real low, just remember what other people have gone through and how much stronger they've become. So it really helps you out in life and can help you get through things.
I'm Dakota Bacon reporting from WSTC News. Back to you.
Well, that's all the time we have for WSTC News. Thanks for watching.
Stay classy and have a great week.
Snow days. He told me to not laugh at elephants, and then he kept saying elephants.
I need to learn how to smile. Go to smiling school.
Elefante es grande. Okay.
Start me.
Ambria, stop.
Learn how to smile. Go to smiling school.
I wasn't expecting Mrs. Food.
Wee! The wide world of sports.
I need to learn how to smile. Go to smiling school.
I got what? That?
What?
Hello and welcome to WSTC Sports.
I'm blinded by the light.
Katie.
She really wants to.
She wants to get this over with.
I had Red Bull today.
That's not good. You're supposed to have a poop.
Shine bright like a diamond.
Do not.
I took that.
You need to learn how to smile. Go to smiling school.
Oh, do you need my Adderall?
Yes.
Yellow.
It's moving.
Welcome.
Huh?
WSTC News.
Oh, yeah.
How do you feel about Jordan's retaliation on ISIS?
Guten Abend. Ich bin durstig. Die Milch ist gut. Das Vater ist kalt. Ich muss einen Apfel haben.
All right, thanks.